January 7th, 1993, Memphis, Tennessee. George Klein live for TNT. The Elvis Stamp celebration on stage. A lot of great entertainment. We have a live on-stage performance tent tonight. We have people from all over the world. They line up all around the block, 5,000 strong in a driving rain. But they are here, and they're proud to get that first stamp. George Klein on location for TNT with the mayor of Shelby County. His wife graduated in the same high school class as yours truly and Elvis. He traveled with Elvis some. He was a dear friend as well as a mayor of the city. Bill, what was the, Mayor Bill Morris, by way of introduction, what was the greatest contribution Elvis made to the city of Memphis?
Well, George, I think we have to step away from the very personal aspect and say for the community, we learned about tourism in this community because of Elvis Presley, and now it's a $2 billion per year industry in our city. And when we talk about economy and the economy, economic growth in this community, we have to think about tourism. And Elvis is the reason why we are enjoying the tremendous popularity of people coming to our city today.
What would you think that he would think about tonight, Bill?
Oh, he would be having a heck of a good time. As you know, George, you and I have been right here with Elvis over the many, many years ago, and he'd be here and he'd say, boy, isn't this is fantastic.
He was very patriotic.
Finest American I ever knew. He was patriotic. He was a good law-abiding citizen, and he was a supporter. You know, I was a sheriff back many years ago, and he was one of the greatest supporters that we had during those years.
This is Mayor Bill Morris of Memphis, Tennessee, ladies and gentlemen, our Shelby County Mayor. One final little quickie. Is it true that you may run for governor of Tennessee?
George, that's a good rumor, and I like it.
That's Bill Morris, my dear friend, ladies and gentlemen. Don't go away, because coming up, Bill, we have a fine little video clip of some ladies who actually got to kiss the king in motion pictures on screen and off screen, and it's going to be quite interesting. So you folks stand by. That's coming up next on TNT. It's Elvis Week, and I'm George Klein with Mayor Bill Morris live from Graceland in Memphis for the Elvis Stamp Celebration anniversary.
This presentation is brought to you by the Elvis Collection. Rarely seen photos, little known stories about the king of rock and roll.
George Klein live, Graceland, Memphis, Elvis Stamp birthday celebration. This little lady, Gail Stanton, I got her a date with Elvis. What kind of kisser was Elvis, Gail?
Fantastic. Ooh, and much more.
And much more, all right. Oh. How would you have liked to have been kissed by Elvis?
Oh, I love it.
How would you?
I'd die. That'd be great.
All right.
Hi, George.
How would you like to have been kissed by Elvis?
I'd love it.
All right. How about you back here?
I'm busy eating.
You're busy eating. Okay, and how about you, this lady back here?
In a second. I would love to be kissed by Elvis. Absolutely.
All right, you back here.
Absolutely.
You back here.
Okay. I'd love it. I'd love it.
All right. Oh, how about her?
What do you be there?
How would you like to be kissed by Elvis?
I don't think, as far as the screen image goes, there is anyone as sick as Elvis was.
It was just something that he was born with. And the cameras loved him.
God, he was gorgeous. But everybody thought he was gorgeous. It wasn't just me. Men and women alike, it was just...
Baby, hold me tight.
Elvis Presley wasn't only the king of rock and roll. In the 50s and 60s, he was also the king of the silver screen. With a few exceptions, the formula for the Elvis movies was pretty much the same. A few songs.
When motors walk, and she's putting the sweet.
A little comedy.
And chocolate mousse.
Chocolate mousse, without the antlers.
And dozens of babes in bikinis. And through them all, the king cast his sexy spell on some of Hollywood's most alluring young starlets. With most of them, the romance stopped when the director called cut.
We were buddies, because when I met Elvis, I was married. And we were always just very good friends.
Elvis was very sensitive about who a person was and what they needed. And so I was very shy, and he treated me like a princess. He treated me with such care, like I was a hothouse flower.
I am 19 years old, and I'm
kind of well-built.
Yep, I know that too. And I'm glad of it.
But some leading lady found Elvis just as irresistible off-screen. Like that, Follow That Dream co-star Anne Helm enjoyed a location romance with Elvis.
It's kind of sweet. I can talk about it now because I'm an old lady. And but I did. I fell in love with him. I just thought he was the best.
Doesn't everybody want to fall in love?
We just had a lovely romance, and it was sweet and tender. I wouldn't change it for a moment. You know, like coming back was very hard, but... because we came back to all the fanfare and the crazy ladies and, no, it was different. The last scene in the film that we did, he sang the song called Angel to me. And we were really saying goodbye in life, in our personal life. You know, our relationship was sort of ending and we were becoming friends. So it was my farewell scene to Elvis in a way.
It's the extra camera. What you get postcard Elvis with a new generation.
Elvis was a big admirer of Frank Sinatra's, yes. I used to joke a lot about Frank, too, because, I mean, he knew that I was going out and we were having a thing, you know, on the side. And there was a lot of jokes that used to go back and forth. Now, we would be in his trailer sitting, and one of his cronies would say, Frank's here! You know, and it became a joke, and indeed, one day, Frank was there. And thank God we were just sitting there and caught something. And said, hi, Frank!
Deborah Wally's friend with Elvis explored a side of him that you saw.
We were not lovers, we were friends and spiritual partners. Elvis was my teacher spiritually. He introduced me to a whole way of looking at life. He started me out on a spiritual path that I've been on ever since.
Friend, lover, teacher, Elvis would need things to meet with. But one thing all his leading ladies shared was their admiration for his talent and for the animal magnetism that drove women wild.
He had that quality that it was a fascination. You couldn't look away from him.
But on stage, he turned into this animal, and he was wonderful, wonderful.
He's an artist. Elvis was an artist.
Long after their on-screen liaisons with the King, Elvis's co-stars remember him fondly as charming, fun-loving, and professional. What everyone really wanted to know after all these years is...
What was it like to kiss Elvis Presley?
It's neat.
It was nice to be kissing someone that you liked and doing romantic scenes with someone that you liked. And then you could both back away from it and laugh.
It was a little simple, innocent kiss, so I don't know how he really kissed. I would imagine he could kiss pretty good.
Oh, yeah, he's kissed real good. And more than that, too.
TNT's special delivery continues next on TNT.
And that's where the very first Elvis stamp is going to make its debut in just a little over half an hour now. We've been here since 7 tonight, over 5,000 away in the rain. For the first Elvis stamp, he came all the way from Great Britain. You came from across the ocean, huh?
That's correct, yeah.
That's right.
And how's the Queen?
Fine, thank you.
Tell her I said hello.
Hello.
And take this weather back when you go back.
We will take it back.
All right, these people came all the way. We got people here from Paris. We got them from Brazil, Australia, all over the world here tonight. I'm George Klein on location, and in just about a half an hour now, that first stamp is going to be sold. And we're going to tell you about it first on TNT. Now, coming up now is a motion picture called Viva Las Vegas. It stars Elvis and Anne Margaret. Elvis's pet name for Anne Margaret was Rusty Ammo. The reason being Anne Margaret's real name was Anne Margaret Olson. Her name in the movie is Rusty, so we called her Rusty Ammo. Now, Richard Davis and I happened to be at a house in Beverly Hills one night when Anne Margaret came up to visit Elvis, and we're going to tell you that story on our first break within the movie. So stay with us. Here comes a great motion picture shot on location in Las Vegas, Nevada, called Viva Las Vegas, one of Elvis's best. George Klein on location for TNT at Graceland in Memphis, Tennessee. Stay with us. You're going to see what you like and like what you see tonight. I promise that's a guarantee from the Jika and your television speaker. So stay with us. right here in Memphis, the first big media event in the history of America for 1993. I'm George Klein on location live at Graceland for TNT. And don't go away, because in just a few minutes, Richard Davis, who was Elvis's stand-in in 23 of the King's 33 movies, he'll be here with yours truly, and we'll be telling you an inside story about Elvis and Ann Margaret. Right now, from old high school, it's now a junior high, this is the Humes Junior High Show Choir. One, two, three, four, hit it!
Going to a party at the county jail. The prisoners that was there, they began to wail. The band was jumping in and all began to swing. You should have heard it knock down jail first thing. Let's rock.
Let's rock.
Everybody, let's rock.
Hey, one more time.
Everybody in the wholesale block.
We're singing.
Was dancing to the jailhouse rock.
Rock, rock.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're looking at Elvis's very first pink and white Cadillac. That was the car that he bought for his mom. Gladys couldn't drive, but Elvis kept it as a memento, as a treasure through many, many years, and it still remains at Graceland to this very day where we are right now, and it's quite a night here. It's history in the making, the debut of the Elvis Presley postage stamp. Over 300 million will be sold in America and worldwide. Also at midnight, it's Elvis's birthday. And with us tonight, on location here at Graceland, he was a stand-in in 20. He was in 23 of Elvis's 33 motion pictures. He was a stand-in. He was a bodyguard. He controlled Elvis's wardrobe when Elvis went back on the road in 69. Richard E. Davis.
How you doing, George?
Richard, this is a most historic moment. What Elvis would have thought about tonight?
Oh, George, he'd been very proud of this. Very proud. This is quite an event, and I think if this would have made him very happy.
Richard, you know, Elvis made the motion picture called Viva Las Vegas. We were, before we went over to Vegas on location, this is an inside story. So, Ann, Margaret, honey, if you're watching, turn your TV off. But anyway, Richard, you know, Elvis was living on Perugia Way up in Bel Air in Beverly Hills.
Right.
And it was me and you, Alan Fortis, and Jimmy Kingsley, bless their hearts, may they rest in peace.
Right.
But anyway, Elvis said, Ann Margaret is coming up tonight. I want you guys to get lost. Don't be around. We said, sure, Elvis. Tell him what happened, Richard.
Well, we went with Elvis to pick her up, brought her back up to Perugia Way, and so Elvis told us to get lost. So they go in the den in Perugia Way, and we supposedly have gotten lost. But you and Alan Fortis, God rest his soul, Jim Kingsley and myself are hiding, peeking through the drapes. And Elvis puts on some slow music, and he and Ann Margaret are slow dancing. But it's the first time I've ever seen him slow dance, too. And during their slow dance, Ann tells him that he looks good in blue, because he had something blue on that night. So the very next day, he sends me out to buy all these blue clothes and stuff, right? but anyway, he catches us speaking at him, right? And spying on him.
Right.
So we all take off running. And we knew which way to go, but you didn't. You ran to a glass door and almost broke your nose.
And I bounced back and bounced up, and Elvis grabbed me by the collar,
right,
and kicked me in the seat of the pants and said, you guys get out of here.
Right.
But Ann Margaret was a nice lady, wasn't she?
She was a very nice lady. Her nickname was Rusty Ammo.
And that was because?
Her name in the movie was Rusty, and her initials are Ann Margaret Olsen, so we call her Rusty Ammo.
Richard Davis, who was Elvis's movie stand-in, he also was Michael St. Gerard's stand-in in the series Elvis, the early years. Richard, your most favorite memory of Elvis?
Oh, George, there were so many of them. I don't think I could pinpoint any of them specifically. But living with Elvis was hard work at times, but it was a lot of fun. We had a lot of good memories that we shared with each other, both off the set and on the set. And working for Michael St. Gerard as his stand-in in the Elvis TV series was like deja vu all over again, because I was Elvis' stand-in and Michael's, and it was a lot of fun.
Richard, Elvis gave all the guys bracelets in the group and had their nickname on the back. In the back of his bracelet was Crazy. Why was that?
Because he was crazy.
He had
a fantastic sense of humor, and he liked to pull practical jokes on us guys, and we did on him, and even total strangers. If you're around us long enough, eventually we're going to get you with something. So we called him Crazy.
Richard, how would you describe Elvis in one word?
The most generous, loving person I've ever met in my life.
Ladies and gentlemen, George Klein, we're live from Graceland, and Richard is just about a little over 7 minutes now, and that stamp is going to make its debut. People from Paris, from Holland, from Italy, from Germany, from Australia are here tonight. It's a fun night, isn't it?
It's a great night.
Folks, stay with us. We're right in the middle of Viva Las Vegas. It's a great movie with Ann Margaret. And then, of course, that returns next Sunday right here on TNT Television. I'm George Klein, live on location at Graceland for the Turner Network Television people. Stay with us, America. Very first Elvis stamp is going to be sold in just a few seconds now, right here live from Graceland in Memphis. You've been in line for a long, long time, little lady. Are you excited?
A long time. I am just so excited. I came from California, and I want to buy these stamps.
Well, bless your heart. We're just about ready. How long have we got, ladies?
1 minute.
We got 1 minute and counting. And you, where'd you come from, sir?
I live here in Memphis.
All right. You, where'd you come from?
I live here in Memphis.
All right, let's talk to the stamp people. How long you guys been waiting?
Since about 9:30.
Are you excited?
Oh, yes, we're real excited.
Would you think this is probably the most historic moment in the history of the United States of America Post Office?
Yes, yes.
How many stamps do you have on sale available tonight, do you know?
300,000.
300,000. There's over 300 million, I understand, that has been printed up for the world. So it's going to be a most historic moment. Little Eddie, you're so lucky to be there to get that stamp. You don't know how many people have asked me to get a stamp from, and I got to get back in line, and there's 5,000 people in line. People have been out here since about 9 o'clock this morning waiting for these stamps. This is one of the satellite post offices. How many are on location, do you know?
Four.
Okay, and there is one over at Graceland. Now, after they buy the stamp, you walk away, and then they put it on the envelope, and then they get it canceled where?
Under the tent.
Oh, under the tent over there. There's going to be some ceremonies. So what is your first name?
Sherry.
Sherry, after you buy the stamp, Sherry from Los Angeles, you'll go over to the tent area, and then you'll have it postmarked. It'll be canceled and postmarked that you were here on January 8th, 1973, when the very first Elvis Presley postage stamp was sold. That's going to be quite exciting.
I'm excited. I just can't wait.
Are your friends back in California watching?
I have notes that I'm going to send them. I wrote out letters, and I'm going to send those to them.
Okay, very good. Are you guys about ready? All right, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This is it. Here we go. All right, look at it. All right. Give me them stamps. Give me them stamps. Give me them stamps. I want them. I want them. There you go, ladies and gentlemen. The very first Elvis Presley postage stamp sold in history right here at Graceland in Memphis, Tennessee. A most historic moment. And those stamps are really gorgeous. The artist did himself well, ladies and gentlemen, by drawing that picture. And the clerks from the United States Post Office are selling those stamps. They have 300,000 available to the public here tonight at Graceland in Memphis, Tennessee. There's Pat Kerr-Jigrid over there. I see a lot of familiar faces. Jerry Lee Lewis was here tonight. The Memphis Horns, Sam Phillips, Rufus, and Carla Thomas. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to break, and we're going to go back to the great motion picture starring Elvis and Anne Margaret, Viva, Viva Las Vegas. Live from Graceland in Memphis, George Klein for TNT.
And for the Postal Service, I'd like to present you with these special albums, which contains sheets of Elvis stamps for you, Lisa Marie, Danielle, and Benjamin.
Thank you very much, Mr. Runyon. Wow. And thank you, everyone. Boy, this is high here. Can I lower this? Can I see you all? Can you see me? How you doing? Okay, listen. This is wonderful. What a great honor. Like all of you here tonight, I feel that if ever there was an entertainer who deserved to be honored with a stamp, unquestionably it'd be Elvis Presley. What he contributed to our music and our culture was enormous and is worthy of the greatest respect and appreciation. He was a brilliant artist and he was a good man. I want to thank all you Law fans and of course the U.S. Police for making this stamp possible. And I'd also like to thank everyone on the Graceland staff for this unbelievable, wonderful event that you've created here. This is terrific. I would also like to thank Colonel Parker for being a very vital and significant force in Elvis's career. I'm sorry that he couldn't be here this evening to help celebrate this very special occasion. He's been very supportive and a very good friend to all of us here at Graceland. Thank you, Mr. Runyon, for these beautiful commemoratives for Lisa and her daughter, Danielle, and her new little son, Benjamin. Lisa was going to send a note of acknowledgement, but instead of sending an acknowledgement, I think maybe it might be better if she thanks you in person. So I'm very happy to introduce to you Lisa Presley Keough.
very honored. Thank you very much. I'm happy to be here. To accept this for my father. It's a great acknowledgement, and I really appreciate it. And I speak on behalf of him and my family and myself. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, a most historic moment here at Graceland in Memphis, Tennessee. Not only Priscilla Presley here, but Lisa Marie Presley, Lisa Marie Presley Keough, has just made her very first public appearance in behalf of her father. The Postmaster General presented the stamps to Priscilla Presley, and then she turns around and introduces her daughter, Lisa Marie Presley Keough. And Lisa Marie, for the very first time, and I repeat, and it bears repeating, this is the first time in history that she has ever made a personal appearance on behalf of her father or the family to make an acknowledgement or accept an award. And you've seen it tonight exclusively right here on TNT television. It's been a wonderful moment, and doesn't she look so marvelous? She looks so much like her father. It's amazing. We're talking about Lisa Marie, and we're so glad that she was here. There was a rumor that she was going to be here. It wasn't for sure. They said, George, there's going to be a surprise guest tonight, and we were all wondering who it was going to be, but it kind of touched our heart when we found out that it was Lisa Marie Presley Keough accepting for Elvis. It's quite a moment. It'll go down in history January 8th, 1993, right here at Graceland, 3764 Elvis Presley Boulevard. And gee, right on the boulevard named after Elvis, his daughter accepts the very first stamp, and in his memory and in his name. It really is a touching moment, and I hope that you certainly enjoyed it. And you've seen it right here on TNT television. Lisa Marie, I understand she has both of her children with her here tonight. Priscilla's also here. And it's very rare also for Priscilla to be at a public appearance and accept an award for Elvis. And I thought it was most honorable that she called out Lisa Marie to pass the torch on to, so to speak. So it was a wonderful night. I know Lisa's manager, Jerry Schilling, is walking back in Los Angeles. Jerry, thank you so much for the insight tonight. We certainly appreciate your help on our broadcast and with Lisa and Priscilla and all. It's been a nice moment, and it's not over yet. So I want you to stay with us because we may have a few more surprises. I'm George Klein. We're live. We're on location at Elvis Presley's house on Elvis Presley Boulevard. We have some fireworks coming up, and TNT is going to carry those live. I understand they're going to shoot off some fireworks up at the Graceland Mansion. There they go. How about that? These are fireworks. And there was one thing that Elvis always liked, especially twice a year. That was on July the 4th and on New Year's. We would always go and buy a whole bunch of fireworks. I remember one time we bought $10,000 worth of fireworks. It all started because Elvis's mom, Gladys Love Presley, bless her heart, may she rest in peace in heaven, she loved fireworks. So we'd go buy a bunch of fireworks, and we'd shoot them off behind Graceland as they're doing right now, much in a similar fashion. And so that continued on for many, many years. I'll never forget one night we were shooting off fireworks, and it was the early 70s, and we got into a situation where we divided up into teams, and we take those Roman candles, and it's kind of crazy now, but we would shoot them at each other. And accidentally, one of the Roman candles went into a big batch of fireworks, and they all started exploding. And I said, Elvis, isn't that beautiful? He said, yeah, and it cost me about $5,000. But anyway, we had a lot of fun, and this was a traditional event at Graceland, and I'm certainly glad that Mr. Soden and his staff and Priscilla and Lisa have recreated the event tonight with the fireworks, the stamp ball. Gosh, what a night. It's really been so well planned and so well programmed. I'm so proud to be a part of it. Yours truly, George Klein, and we've had a wonderful moment here at Graceland. Don't go away. We may have a few more surprises for you. As we shoot the fireworks, we're going to go back to our central headquarters. This is George Klein for TNT Live at Graceland in Memphis, Tennessee.
TNT's Elvis special delivery rocks on.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm George. George Klein. Indeed, it's been my pleasure being your host tonight for the Elvis Stamp Celebration in conjunction with his 58th birthday. It has been a most historic moment in Memphis. Behind me, fireworks are going off at Graceland. The stamps are selling like crazy. It's raining like crazy in Memphis, but the people, it doesn't matter to them. They've been standing in line since 9 o'clock this morning. Over 300,000 stamps are being sold here at Graceland tonight. 300 million have been printed. It's been a wonderful event. Don't forget that Turner Network Television will present Elvis the Early Years along with Elvis movies all weekend long on your favorite Turner Network channel. Check listings for time and everything, but it's been a wonderful night. And once again, I want to thank the people at Turner for letting me be here to share it with you. It's a most historic moment. We've had a lot of guests. We want to thank them all. We want to thank our fantastic crew from Turner over in Atlanta for working with us here in Memphis. They have really paid their dues here tonight, and they are a wonderful, marvelous crew. We thank all of you in the trailer there back in Atlanta. Thanks so very much. And we ended up, and we say, ladies and gentlemen, that the sun never sets on a legend. There'll always be a TCB on the Lisa Marie. The United States of America had 41 presidents, but only one king. And tonight, he got that extra jewel in his crown. He got that stamp. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm George Klein. God bless you, and thanks for joining us from Memphis, Tennessee at Graceland, 3764 Elvis Presley Boulevard. This is GK. Take it away, Atlanta. You've got it on TNT.